the mystery is really the thing, isn't it? And I listened to your debate with Kent Hovind on the way up, and what always fascinates me about believers is the willingness to simply give that mystery up to God, when really all we need is, you know, everybody's willing to admit that they don't know, but then that half of the public seems to just say, okay, well, since we don't know, it must be God. And I can't get my head around that. How do good, intelligent minds abandon the simple search of science? People seem to think that science is a different religion, or evolution is a different religion. And really, it's just the unanswered question is the unanswered question. Why is it that people are so concerned with filling in that answer before we've fully investigated?
Well, I think the world is so big, too. I mean, most people are probably scientifically ignorant just because it's impossible for our brain to hold all the information. Like, who could be an expert in biological evolution and neurology and cosmology?
Right.
You know, so if you don't know anything about cosmology, but everything about biology and neurology, maybe you'll say, like, well, I don't know about cosmology. Obviously, God is needed to create a Big Bang, you know. So maybe there's always that, you know, that thing we don't know where, you know, it's so amazing. It's got to be God, because it just blows our mind.
Did you think that it's that? I mean, I don't know anything about architecture, but I see some tall buildings around. I mean, do you think it's more the meaning of life? Like, why are we here? That there must be a God, because otherwise, really, I'm going to go through this entire life, you know, what, raising kids, which is a lot of work, and so on and so forth. To me, it seems like the meaning of life and the fear of death. It's probably the two that really are probably the hardest to kick off.
Yeah, you know, but part of it, too, is actually the so-called God delusion. And I'm not sure... I just kind of know bits and pieces from Richard Dawkins' book. I don't know, and he may not cover this, but when I was a Christian, one thing that solidly grounded me was my feelings of relationship with God. And, you know, that's one thing Christians always say to atheists, too. It's like, well, you don't have the feelings of God. You don't know God exists. I know God exists like my spouse exists. And it's like, yeah, I've been there. And you know, like William Lane Craig, for example, one of the most famous Christian apologists, you know, he says, but these feelings are one of the biggest reasons why he personally believes, even though he doesn't think, you know, they're good evidences, so he wouldn't bring them up in a debate. But personally, that's one of the biggest reasons why he believes. So, I believe the only way to override that delusion is by knowing the truth. It's just like, for example, you know, it's easy to think the Earth is built on a solid foundation. We're not moving, but at the equator, we're, you know, they're spinning like 1,000 miles per hour. It's like that. How there's no way. How would that happen? How could that be? I don't feel it.
Right.
You know, but it's the knowledge that is a counter to your feelings.
It's a good point too. We're whipping through, like, the galaxy is whipping through space even faster than that. So yeah, you're right. We are. Mm-hmm. We're booking.
I'm fascinated at how a creationist arguer like Kent Hovind is able to simply spin every argument you throw at him his way. It's so easy to. I mean, do you find it difficult, or do you enjoy debating these guys, or is it? You seem to be a really, maybe it's the Pacific Northwest in you, a really even keeled character when you're faced with what would, to me, would be mind bogglingly frustrating circles of logic.
That frustrating.
They seem so easily dispensed from the mouths of these creationists, isn't it? How do you get past that when you debate them, when they're just willing to take everything you say and give it to God?
I guess one thing I had one, you know, TV discussion with Kent Hovind, and I got another one coming up. But the first one is, you know, it's kind of just trying to get into his head and understand who he is, kind of thing. And you know, he says some funny things like, hey, you know, in the Ark, they had all these, you know, I said, what about T-Rex on the Ark? They have all these animals in the Ark. How would you feed them? And he goes, well, farmers just throw out a bale of hay and they'll feed themselves. You know, they're all vegetarians. Like, the T-Rex was eating hay, you know? And I go, you know, like, how does that make sense? And he goes, well, it makes more sense than evolving from a rock.
Right.
So it's like, okay, well, you're seeing what his alternatives are and how he's thinking.
Well,
and, you know, and it was kind of funny, too, where, you know, he says he has 3 or 4 doctorate degrees. And so, you know, I questioned about those because, you know, I did research before it that, you know, I found out that they're diploma mill, you know, and it was kind of funny to try to corner him on that one. But
I was fascinated to learn that the animals were all vegetarians before the flood. I did not know that.